Nearly a dozen people are reportedly injured after a magnitude 6.4 earthquake jolted northern Philippine provinces late Tuesday. Our very own Bianca Dava is there in Abra, and she joins us live for the latest. Good morning, Bianca. What can you tell us?
Nikki, barely 3 months after a magnitude 7 earthquake hit Abra in July, another earthquake struck the province just a few days ago. Most of the affected residents are still afraid to return to their homes and have set up tents outside as temporary shelter. Abra Congresswoman Menchie Berno said most of the damaged infrastructures here in the province are houses. Some are totally destroyed and many are partially damaged. So far, the provincial government, local government units, and the Department of Social Welfare and Development have provided assistance in the form of food packs and tents to affected residents. In the town of Lagayan, which is the quake's epicenter, cracks are seen at the Pulot National High School building as a result of the shaking. Various equipment and objects inside classrooms and offices also toppled over. The newly constructed Lagayan Municipal Hall also incurred damage. Employees were supposed to move here this November. However, this seems to be postponed. Weekend structures like the Iglesia Filipina Independiente Church in La Paz town sustained greater damage. Now, during the first quake in July, the church already sustained a few cracks. But following Tuesday night's earthquake, a huge portion of the belfry had completely fallen. The quake also left larger cracks on the church's walls and ceilings. Reverend Father Christian Edward Padua said it will be hard to rehabilitate the church, which was built in 1895, especially when the original materials will be used. He also cannot estimate the cost of damage to the church, saying such a structure is considered priceless. Nikki, no fatalities were reported, but the Provincial Disaster Risk Reduction and Management Office of Abra says that at least 10 people were injured in the quake. Now, we're still feeling some aftershocks here in Abra, and according to FIVOC, 528 aftershocks were recorded since 7 last night, and of these tremors, 6 were felt. Nikki?
All right, thanks for that update, Bianca. You and the team stay safe. Meanwhile, President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. vows government assistance for residents in quake-hit areas. He says right now they're focused on providing temporary shelters to those in need.
We have sent ang hinihingi ng karamihan ay tent. And the reason why is ayaw nilang, natatakot silang bumalik sa bahay nila. We do not have a critical problem when it comes to food, maybe shelter. That is the most important part of the relief that we have to provide now for the people affected by the earthquake.